हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम एनके जैन फ्रॉम skillontech.com। टुडे आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग सेकंड वीडियो इन सीरीज ऑफ इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस। टाइप ऑफ फ्लैंजेज। एज वी नो, फ्लैंजेज आर यूज्ड टू कनेक्ट पाइपलाइंस इन इंडस्ट्रीज। सो वी मस्ट नो व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लैंजेज एंड व्हिच फ्लैंजेज आर मेनली यूज्ड इन द इंडस्ट्रीज। What are type of flanges used in steel piping? First, screwed, silicone flanges, socket weld flanges, weld neck flanges, lap joint flanges, blind flange, etc. Classes of flange rating. The question is very important. Flange ratings are classified based on pressure and temperature rating as ANSI, ASME, B16.5. Generally, these ratings are 150 pound rating, 300 pound rating, 400 pound rating, 600 pound rating, 900 pound rating, 1500 pound rating, or 2500 pound rating. So, what is this rating? Pressure rating is defined as the maximum allowed pressure that a flange can withstand at increasing temperatures. According to the ANSI-ASME B16.5 specification, there are 7 flange pressure ratings. So, when temperature increases in the system, the flange rating will also increase. Even though pressure may remain same, but temperature is increasing. If pressure alone is increasing, then also flange rating will be increased. If both are increasing, then suitable flange rating shall be used for pipeline as per pressure and temperature. So, what are the flange classifications? How can flanges be classified as per face? Flat face, denoted by FF, raised face, RF, tongue and groove, male and female face, ring type joint, RTJ. How flanges can be classified based on flange surface finish? So there are two finishes. One is smooth finish, another one is serrated finish. In smooth finish flanges, the flange finish shall be 125 RA and spiral wound gaskets always require a smooth finish. In serrated finish faces, we can use graphite gaskets, asbestos gaskets, etc. In serrated finish flange faces, we should not use spiral wound gaskets. Where blind flange is used, you can see a picture of blind raised face flange. It is used with view to future expansion of the piping system or for cleaning, inspection, etc. Blind flanges are used where we have to block the flow of the pipeline. Where spectacle flanges used, you can see picture of spectacle blind and flange. The spectacle blind is usually used on the oil line with two different functions. If the spade is put in between the flanges, it stops the fluid passage. If the spacer is put in between the flanges, the passage of the fluid is allowed. So, the direction of the spectacle blind is changed as per the requirement of the flow. Flange finish. Where the smooth finish flange and serrated finish flanges find its use, as we earlier discussed. A smooth finish flange is provided when metallic gaskets, spiral wound gasket is provided. Serrated finish flange is provided when non-metallic gasket is provided. So therefore, in serrated finish flange, we can use rubber gasket, asbestos or graphite gaskets that can be used. But spiral wound gaskets cannot be used in serrated finish flanges, otherwise flange joint will leak. And when we have to use spiral wound gaskets, that is a requirement of a smooth finish flange. If a smooth finish flange is there, then only we have to use spiral wound gasket. What are the type of serrated finish provided on flange face? So there are two types: concentric, spiral, phonographic. Short and long radius elbow. You can see a picture of 90 degree short radius elbow, 90 degree long radius elbow. Where do we use short and long radius elbow in piping? Long radius elbows are used for a small pressure drop, whereas short radius elbows are used for high pressure drops. For catalyst flows, very long radius elbows are used. Short radius elbows are used in jacketed piping, usually in small bores. So where the flow velocities are high, we have to use long radius elbows to avoid impingement corrosion. If short radius elbows is used for high pressure, high velocity pipelines, then elbow failures may occur very frequent. Therefore, long radius elbows or 5D bands, 3D bands are used in the pipelines. Miter band. What is miter band? So straight pipe sections welded together to make band with cutting in angle. Generally we used elbows, but sometime we have to use miter band. Miter band can be used in place of elbow also, but in large size of pipelines where elbows are not available, or sometime we have scarcity of elbows, we can fabricate miter band and can be used to provide angle or direction to the pipeline. So straight pipe sections welded together to make band with cutting in angle. Generally it is used in large diameter pipes, largely required when standard elbow bands are not available in large diameter pipes. May require larger thickness. Number of welds will increase, condition, size are criteria. In preparation of miter bands, the weld joints will increase to provide the desired direction to the pipeline. Concentric, eccentric reducers. You can see picture of eccentric reducer and concentric reducers. So where these concentric and eccentric reducers are used? Is concentric reducer used in pump suction? No. Air pocket may form if concentric reducer is used at pump suction, which result in cavitation and cause damage to pump. You can see a picture of this concentric reducer provided in the pump suction, and that sketch show you as a incorrect. To avoid this problem, eccentric reducer with flat side up as shown in the picture is used in pump suction. Normally where do we use concentric or eccentric reducer? Eccentric reducer, pump suction to avoid cavitation, to maintain elevation BOP in rack. Concentric reducer, pump discharge, vertical pipelines, etc. Vent and drain on pipeline. Why high point vent and low point drain provided in piping? HPV, high point vent, for removing air during hydrotest. You can see a picture, typical hydrotest vent and drain point locations, where you can see at the bottom of the pipeline low point drain is provided, and at the highest point of the pipeline high point vent is provided. As we know, the air accumulated in the process pipelines will be released from the top of the highest elevation of the pipeline. So that will try to reach on the highest point. So that's why at highest point, vent point is provided in the pipelines. LPD, फॉर ड्रेनिंग वाटर आफ्टर कंडक्टिंग हाइड्रो टेस्ट. जनरली ड्यूरिंग हाइड्रो टेस्ट वी हैव टू फ्लश द पाइपलाइन एंड आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ हाइड्रो टेस्ट वी हैव टू ड्रेन ऑल द सिस्टम वाटर विच इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी ड्रेन. So for draining water after conducting hydro test, for normal draining and decontamination of piping, drain points are provided. Valdolate, Socolate. You can see a picture of valdolate and socolate. What are valdolate and socolate and where they are used? Valdolate and socolate are basically self-reinforced fittings. Valdolate is used for butt welded branch connections where standard T is not available due to size restriction and the piping is of critical high pressure service. Because in high pressure, high temperature service pipelines about 2 inch and larger dias, we have to make butt weld joints because flat weld joints cannot be radiographed. So, to ensure the weld joint perfectness, a butt weld is provided all the pipelines which are above 2 inch and above 2 inch. So, in those pipelines, when branch connections are taken, valdolate and socolates are provided. Socolate is used for socket welding branch connection which require reinforcing pad. Fit up for butt weld joint. You can see a picture of fit up for butt weld joint where you can see two pipes are adjoined and beveled as to prepare the fit up. So the angle between both the bevels should be 70 degree plus minus 2.5 degree, and this land is 1.1 by 32 inch to 1 by 16 inch, root gap 1 by 8 inch to 5 by 32 inch as per the filler wire. Mismatch allowed is maximum 3 by 32 inch. So why good pipe fit up and tolerances are required prior to welding? Good pipe fit up result in sound weld joint, minimize load on joints, dimensional tolerances are kept in mind, therefore flanges tolerances are to be considered. So a good fit up is required to make a sound weld joint, butt weld joint. Pipe supports and hangers. In all long pipelines we have to provide pipe supports and hangers, otherwise pipe will sag. Why pipe supports and hangers are provided? To prevent pipe stresses in excess to allowable, to eliminate the leakage in joints, to absorb excessive line vibrations, to counter the undesirable effect of seismic, wind, water hammer, slug and other dynamic loadings, to remove unintentional disengagement lift off of piping from its support, to prevent excessive pipe sag, normally more than 10 mm for process piping and 2.5 mm for power piping, 12.5 mm for GRE or GRP piping, to eliminate exposure of elements to temperatures extremes outside their design limit, to limit undesirable line movement, to protect sensitive equipment against overloading, to redirect pipe thermal movements to the favorable direction, to reduce excessive loading in support cell. So, pipe supports and hangers are very important. What is the use of pipe A106 and A53 grade piping? This is very important where we have to use this A106 and A53 grade piping. So there are some other grades in the A106. There are three grades, A106 grade A, B, C, And similarly, in A53, there are three grades, A53, grade ABC. So these are basically carbon steel pipes. ASTM A53 pipes are mainly used for utility services and hot water services. And sometimes low pressure steam also this can be used. Whereas A106 grade B pipes are used for high pressure and high temperature services. A53 seamless pipes are also compatible to A106 pipes. So alternatively, if A106 pipe is not available, A53 pipes can also be used considering the pressure and temperature of the pipeline. Heat tracing. You can see a picture of pipeline where heat tracing is provided. So what is heat tracing in piping system and what are its advantages in industries where atmospheric temperature is very low? The freezing of fluid in the system is a very common problem. So to avoid this freezing in the fluid problem, which occurs generally in winter, this heat tracing is provided. Heat tracing required to maintain temperature of process fluid in pipeline. So there are two types of heat tracing, electrical or steam tracing. It reduces liquid viscosity. It prevents condensate accumulation. Heat tracing should be turned on when process is off. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.